Joe Biden's been on the Japanese media quite often recently, but seems like he's not popular. To be fair, Trump wouldn't be either for the following two reasons. For those who don't know, these news have been widely reported in Japan, emphasizing the craziness of Trump, which obviously doesn't give us a positive impression about him. And surprisingly, many people in Japan still remember and believe that many Asians, including Japanese residents in the States, had a quite hard time because of Trump. Anyway, most people in Japan, including myself, wouldn't support Biden or Trump either. But the better question would be, which one do we like the least? And surprisingly, Biden might be the one for the three big reasons. As you know, Japan's been suffering from this and still can't fix it. In this nation, many of the businesses heavily depend on imports, so we've been severely affected by the consequences. And recently, many of the economics or experts in Japan point out that's because Biden printing money too much and caused a huge inflation to begin with. So the US was forced to raise interest rates a lot, while Japan couldn't catch up. Japan's bank finally took action, but we're still anxious if it actually works, and starting to direct the frustration toward Biden, especially given the fact that he doesn't seem to care about it.
Are you taking blame for inflation, Mr. President?
Are you taking blame for inflation? No.
Why not?
Because it was already there when I got here, man. Remember what the economy was like when I got here? Jobs were hemorrhaging. Inflation was rising. We weren't manufacturing a damn thing here. We were in real economic difficulty. That's why I don't.
Mr. President!
While Trump at least seems concerned about that, and we see him blaming Biden for it. And to us, Biden doesn't seem to care or understand how devastating the weak yen is for Japan. Not just about the price hike, but fewer Japanese could go to the States. While the weak yen brings many US tourists here, traveling or study abroad in the States became almost impossible for us. College in the States already super expensive, but used to be one of the most popular countries for Japanese people to study in. So those people dislike Biden, making the country even more expensive for us.
Knowing the average salary in Japan, I just don't think parents support, you know, their children, you know, going to US. It's just really expensive. It's crazy.
But some of us rather go to the country because of the strong US currency, which might be often dangerous or illegal.
海外とかでやってる方がそっちの方にみんな流れてっちゃわないかなってちょっと心配ではあります。
Our reputation getting worse for that, so it's getting even harder for us to enter the country, which is really unfortunate. Although none of the issues I mentioned entirely Biden's fault, many people in Japan say that's something we didn't see when Trump was the president. Actually, they claim Trump cared about Japan much more, and point out during the 4 years, he was the one who spent time the most with our prime minister at that time, much more than any other leaders or Biden. And because many of us compare to that, it feels like Biden doesn't careabout Japan so much. But this might be a bigger reason that more and more people in Japan dislike Biden, as we have the highest number of US military members in the world. Some people say we have too many, and when it comes to foreign policy and US military bases, Trump consistently made the stance clear during the 4 years.
As President of the United States, I will always put America first.
And I'm sure some people are against it and disliking Trump for that. But recently in Japan, seems like that's what more and more peoplecame to prefer. That social preference was caused by the public backlash against it, as even some of the same party and the Ministry of Finance also not really happy about it. The cabinet's been losing support and trust more and more since then, and he actually ended up the most unpopular one after the World War II in Japan. Aside from the recent scandal in his party, the public disapproval on the increase was a quite big reason, and this has been more and more supported so that Trump happened to be better. Especially his partyconstantly claiming that in public and gaining support for it.
最も重視する政策を有権者に聞いた 43% が経済と答えた。最優先課題は経済なんですよ。
30年経済が悪い国、まずは経済なんですよ。
アメリカに復讐を誓うって者たちもいます。アメリカは敵であるという見方をしている人たちに対して日本も同じに見られると。日本国内でテロが起こることもあり得るってこと。
トランプさんが、大統領だった時は縮小していく方向にまずは進むっていうことのきっかけを与えてくれたのかな。一方でバイデンさんですけれども、今やってることは完全なる武器商人ですね。死の商人ですね。
美味しい儲け方をしようとしてるってことです。オフショアバランシングってやつですね。
これ何ですかって言ったらビジネスなんですよ。オフショアバランシング、
オフショアバランシング、
いつまでもそれをやろうとしているっていうのが今のバイデンさんじゃないですか。
ATM 化してしまうってことはやっぱり下げなければならないってことです。
While the Prime Minister claims that increase is necessary as the tension between China and Taiwan has been rising and we need to prepare for that, although few countries meet the goal, spending 2% of GDP is considered standard in NATO, so it's not so crazy idea that we increasing the amount, but many people argue and claim that's not the direction we want, and as they're pushing the opinion, they are more and more supported by the public recently.
台湾有事っていうものを招いてしまった時に日本は無傷ではいられない。軍事力を高めて阻止できるかっつったらかなり難しい。だってアメリカでさえもこうなんですから。つまりは何か平和外交を貫く以外はこれ道はないと思ってます。
武力で平和は作れないっていうことは歴史が証明している。戦争を起こさせないっていうことがとても大事で、
ほとんどアメリカから兵器を輸入しているので外国に払うお金がどんどん増えていくだけになっちゃうので、ここは慎重に考えなきゃいけないなと。
トランプ大統領になった場合に米軍の数っていうものが減っていくことによっておそらく周辺国とのやり取りっていう部分も外交っていう部分ももっと進んでいくと思うんですね。そういうような形が実現できるんじゃないかな、そう思ってます。
To be honest, I'm not so sure if that's actually true, but the point is more and more people believe it, and that's why disliking Biden, especially given the fact that he called us xenophobic, and many of us disagree and upset. To be fair though, some of the residents in Japan would totally agree with Biden on that, especially those who are perceived as foreigners, as they actually receive a xenophobic treatment in Japan. But this side obviously not convinced and frustrated by the Biden.Comment, categorizing us in the same group as China and Russia. They claim it doesn't make sense Japan's having so many US tourists or residents if this country was xenophobic or racist.
いや、そんなないと思いますけど。
ないですか？
だってあったら来てないでしょ。って感じですね。
But based on my observation in Japan, what caused the division is the wording choice. To them, it would be more accurate to use these words, as they claim that they have no hard feeling or hatred towards any foreigners, while the other side rather choose more aggressive words like Biden, which completely change the image of Japan, and that's why wording is important. But we still can't see eye to eye on that, because we have different definition on those terms.
People's concept of what is racist?Really depends on the person.
To be fair though, it's true that many Koreans or Chinese residents have a hard time, and probably we should all agree that is racism based on hatred. But what about these actions towards white people or black people in Japan? Is it really based on hatred? Most Japanese people I talk to find it hard to call those xenophobic.
なんか私自身そういうことあんまり思ったことがないので難しいですね。それ差別なのかな。
Maybe not necessary a racism.
いや、ないですね。
あ、ないですか？
ないです。
もちろんある。日本の人で、だ露骨に外国人だから避けるっていう人もいる。僕の隣に座ろうと思って向かってきた人がハッと僕に気づいて別の方に移動しちゃう。たびたびあるんですよ。露骨な人がいたりするんですよ。
Just go to the grocery store and, you know, everyone stares at you, turns their head, you know, kids will like tug on their mom, be like, oh, look.
I've heard a lot of Japanese people say there's no racism in Japan.
根っからの差別主義者で悪人だとは思わなかったけど、良くないと異常なことだっていうふうに解釈していなかった。
なんか接する機会がないっていうのがあるかもしれないですね。
Even though I look Japanese, I think for Japanese people, I'm not the typical Japanese kid. So they're like, oh, okay, like you're a foreigner. I'm like, oh, well, I speak Japanese too. That is something I think a lot of returnees have a difficulty with.
そういうのは考えない。
え、考えないです。え、でも結構そうですよね。なんか言われてみれば問題視してる方々っていますもんね。
教えていく
べきだっていう人ですね。はいはいはいはい。それもどうなんですかね。どうなんだろう。そういうのでこうズーンってなりたくないので、別になんか教育にはね取り込むまではしなくてもいい気がしますね。うん。
But whoever is going to be chosen as the next US president, I really hope people in Japan wouldn't change the impression of the US or people. I believe the country and president would be completely two different things, and that person doesn't represent anything or anyone in the States, as the country is too big and too diverse, and the popular votes wouldn't be necessarily reflected unlike in Japan. So regardless of the outcome this year, hopefully we won't judge you based on your president.